How to update and how to add the Aeotec Z-Stick 7 in Home Assistant using the Z-Wave GS integration. The whole point of doing this is to add a Z-Wave controller in your smart home so you can control and automate Z-Wave compatible devices inside Home Assistant. I just said a lot of confusing words, so I'll quickly start to explain them one by one, and then we will continue to the actual implementation. And if you want some further explanation of smart home words and acronyms, check my smart home glossary, which is available free of charge on my website. So, let's quickly talk about Z-Wave first. Z-Wave is a wireless communications protocol used primarily for home automation. It is a mesh network using low energy radio waves to communicate from appliance to appliance. A Z-Wave network system can be controlled via the internet or locally from a smartphone, smart speaker, computer or home assistant. That was Z-Wave in essence. But what is Z-Wave GS? Z-Wave GS is an open source Z-Wave driver that is actively developed and supported, and basically it is the recommended Z-Wave integration method for home assistant. I'm constantly talking about Home Assistant here and in my other videos. If you want to know more about how to install Home Assistant and what are the possible and official installation types, I have a Home Assistant webinar for you, where in around 45 minutes you understand everything so you can make an informed decision what is your Home Assistant installation type. There is also one super easy way to get Home Assistant explained in the webinar. So go check it out, it is completely free. The final thing that I'll talk about before I go to the how-to part of this video is the Aeotec Z-Stick 7. To have a Z-Wave network, you need one controller like the Aeotec Z-Stick. The controller are the heart of the Z-Wave network and they bundle all information locally. Furthermore, they organize the communication between your devices in order to link them with each other. In addition, the controllers act as an interface to you, so you can control everything from a smartphone or from Home Assistant, for example. Aeotec Z-Stick 7 is not the only Z-Wave controller available. There are other sticks like the Zeus, Nortec, Z-Wave and Zigbee combo stick, or hubs like Samsung SmartThings or Hubitat. I choose the Aeotec Z-Stick 7 because it is a Gen 7 device and it uses the latest 700 series Z-Wave technologies. But there is one major bumper with the latest technologies. They have some nasty bugs as this one. This bug, as far as I know, affects all of the Gen 7 sticks, no matter the brand. Fortunately, there is a fix and you just have to firmware update your stick. Unfortunately, the update process is not so easy. But not to worry, I will show you how to update the Aeotec Z-Stick 7 to the latest firmware, step by step. Okay, I'll follow this update Z-Stick 7 with Windows article from Aeotec official website. And inside this article, it says that I should install Simplicity Studio 5. And this is one of the top requirements. So I'm going to do that. Just have in mind that I'm using Windows because it's easier. You also can upgrade your firmware using Raspberry Pi OS as described here. If you wish, you can try the Linux version as well. It should work. So let's start. I'll open this link right here where I'll access the needed software for Windows. I have a video here, but I'll skip it and I'll directly go to the steps. I'll open this link as well. I have to create a Silicon Labs account here. I added my first name, last name, nickname, email address, and company name. Then I'll select a country, create account. I should receive a verification code. Let me check. Yes, I have it. Verify. User registration successful and I can proceed to login. Sorry, but my Roborock just started cleaning. I have to stop it. I have an account now and I'm logged in Silicon Labs website. I'll click on this search button and I'll search for Simplicity Studio Download. Then I'll select the product section and I'll click on the first link here. And this is the whole URL that I needed. I should select Windows here because I'm using Windows at the moment, and the Simplicity Studio 5 ISO is started to download. Next, I should mount the Simplicity Studio 5 ISO and then I should install it. It's 300 megabytes already. Then I have to log in with my same credentials, my Silicon Labs account. Finally, the Simplicity Studio was downloaded. It is around 500 megabytes and I'll double click on it. Then I'll click open and I'll double click as well on the setup.exe. I'll accept the terms and I'll click next, next again, install. I'll accept all agreements and I'll click done. I will log in with my Silicon Labs account. This is a mandatory step because otherwise I'm not able to use the PC controller. I'll tick remember, login. It is fetching some jar files from the internet. As instructed in the support article, I'll select this install by technology type option. Then I'll select the 32-bit and wireless MCUs. Again, as displayed here in the article. And I'll click next. I'll leave auto option here and I'll click next again. I'll accept all agreements. Next. And another installation process, Silicon Labs. What can I say?
1 eternity later.
Whoa, a restart of Simplicity Studio is required now. Okay, finally. Let's see if I can open the Z-Wave PC controller. It is located in Tools. Z-Wave PC controller. Okay. Everything seems fine. So let's continue with the Aeotec 7 Z-Stick. I think I'm ready with that part. And I'll continue with the next step, which is to download the latest Z-Stick 7 firmware. Again, I'll use the links inside this support article. Don't worry, I'll share this article in the video description so you can have it as well. Make sure that you select the right frequency here. EU is for Europe and US is for USA. I'll select EU because I'm located in Europe. The firmware is downloaded and I will insert the Aeotec Z-Stick 7 in my USB slot. Okay, then I'll open the PC controller and I'll click on this gear button. This is the settings menu. And inside I can find the Silicon Labs CP something, which is my stick. I'll select it and I'll click OK. I think I successfully connected to the Aeotec stick. OTW stands for over the wire. I'll click on this. I'll go to my download section. This is the actual firmware update, GBL file. I'll click open. Please wait until the local firmware update completed and some packets are written. Great. Disconnecting. Connected to COM4 after firmware update to Z-Wave 7.17. Great! I successfully updated my Aeotec Z-Stick 7 to the latest firmware. That was the hardest and the most boring part for me today. Now the fun part begins. Namely, I'll add the Aeotec Z-Stick 7 in Home Assistant using the Z-Wave GS integration. Then I'll be able to add Z-Wave devices to my Z-Wave network and I'll be able to control them from Home Assistant. Let's start! This is my test Home Assistant. Inside it I'll press on the C button on my keyboard and this will invoke the search bar. Inside the search bar I'll type integrations and I'll click on Navigate Integrations button. make sure that your Z-Wave stick is inserted in the device where Home Assistant is installed, so it will be able to be detected. And as you can see from this screen right here, my Aeotec device is auto-discovered by Home Assistant, and I can click Configure. Or if your device is not auto-discovered, you should add a new integration, Z-Wave GS integration, and you'll be able to add it that way. So I'll just click on the result here, then on submit. The Z-Wave GS add-on installation has started. This can take several minutes. Okay, after several minutes I have this new dialog. I enter the Z-Wave GS add-on configuration. The add-on will generate security keys if those fields are left empty, and I'm going to leave them empty, and I'll click submit. Please wait. While the Z-Wave GS add-on start completes, this may take some seconds. Okay, I'll wait. And finally, I have this success window. Created configuration for Z-Wave GS. I can select area from here, but I'll leave it like that, and I'll just click finish. Here is my Z-Wave GS device with the updated firmware. Great! It seems that everything is fine so far. I'm ready with the Aeotec Z-Stick 7 Home Assistant integration. Next step is to start adding Z-Wave devices in Home Assistant using the Z-Wave GS integration. My testing Z-Wave device will be again from Aeotec. The exact model is Aeotec Siren 6. And I have to say that this video is not sponsored by Aeotec. I just found the Aeotec Siren 6 nearby really cheap and decided to try it out. This Aeotec Siren actually has some pretty cool features. You can use the Siren not only for security alarm, smoke detection and so on, but also as a doorbell by pairing it with Aeotec button. On top, it has a 4-hour backup battery that lets the Siren work even when power is turned off. If you decide to buy the Siren, the button or the Aeotec Z-Stick 7, you'll find some affiliate links in the video description. If you buy something from there, I'll receive a small commission from your purchase with no additional cost for you. Now, let's add Aeotec Siren 6 in Home Assistant. Okay, let's try to add the Aeotec Siren 6 in Home Assistant. I'll go to integration section, add integration. And as you can see here, I have this add Z-Wave device button. I'll click on it and the searching for devices will start by Home Assistant. I'll grab my Aeotec Siren and I'll press the inclusion button. And it's found it. Great. The device has requested the following security classes: S0, S2 authenticated, and S2 unauthenticated. I'll leave them checked and I'll click submit. Now it asks me for a PIN, the first 5 digits of the PIN. Okay, it is located on the back side of the Siren. It is started with DSK and then some digits. Mine are these, I just enter them and I'll click submit. By the way, do you have any Z-Wave devices in your home already? Let me know in the comment section below. Bonus points if you say what exactly are your Z-Wave devices. The device is being interviewed. This may take some time, okay? Hope that the interview will finish fine. Great! The device has been added. The Aeotec Siren 6 is now inside my Home Assistant, which is great. I can click on this View Device button and I'll close this. And I have a lot of controls, volume for different sounds, sensors, and configuration. Everything is inside my Home Assistant. Because this Aeotec Siren 6 have different ringtones and sirens, I now have them here. This is the default tone when I press this remote button. And I can change that to something other, for example, let's find something short, CO sensor. Now if I press the button again, I also can lower the volume from here. Let's try it. Yay, it is a lot quieter now. I can also click on this configure device button and I can further configure the device. I can set different parameters like duration, interval between tones, play count and so on and so forth. If I go back, oh great, I have now switches. Nice! I can activate the siren. This is the tamper. If you move the Aeotec Siren 6 very rapidly or shake it, it will activate this tone. I will put the volume down on everything because I don't want to hear it while I'm shooting. I'm not sure which is the sound of the tamper. Oh, now it's a lot better. It's very quiet. I can move it freely now because until now I was like frozen. So this default volume 2 is the tamper, and if I click on this button, the siren will start and it is not stopping until I turn it off from here. Great. I can use that for an automation. Let's see it. What do you say about quick Home Assistant automation demo that involved the Aeotec Siren 6 that we just integrated in Home Assistant using the Aeotec Z-Stick 7? Let's see that. I'll go to the Home Assistant automation section. For that, I'll press the C button again and I'll type automations, navigate automations, create automation, start with an empty automation. And the trigger here in this automation can be anything. Motion is detected when nobody is home, strange camera movement, and so on and so forth. I'll not add the trigger. Instead, I'll just add the action to show you how you can use this Aeotec Siren 6. I'll scroll down until I see this action section, and as action type, I'll choose call service. The service will be siren turn on. I'll choose an entity. This entity will be my Aeotec Siren 6. And I can select any of these tones, for example, tone 3. And I can set the duration, let's say 5 seconds. And I'm ready with my automation action section. I can test it by using this 3 dots menu, run action. It is working. The tamper is also working. Everything is fine. Great. I'll see you next Wednesday when I release my new video. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye.